travel to the United Kingdom for the summer conference. ونود بإذن الله تعالى أن نسترجع سريعا شيئا مما قدمنا الكلام عليه حتى يتصل الكلام بعضه ببعض. And I would like to just refresh what we have already explained so that when we speak of about the new session, the talk would be linked together. فيما مضى درسنا الأصول الثلاثة التي يجب على كل مسلم ومسلمة معرفتها وكان السؤال ما الأصول الثلاثة التي يجب على كل مسلم ومسلمة معرفتها. In the past, we studied about the three fundamental principles that every Muslim, male and female, has to be aware of. And the question was, what are these three fundamental principles? وكان الجواب الأصول الثلاثة التي يجب على كل مسلم ومسلمة معرفتها هي معرفة العبد ربه ومعرفة العبد دينه ومعرفة العبد نبيه محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the answer was the three fundamental principles which are obligatory upon every Muslim male and female to be aware of are the worshiper awareness of his Lord, or the worshiper awareness of his religion, and the worshiper awareness of his Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. ثم السؤال الثاني من ربك وما الدليل. Second question was, who is your Lord and what is the proof? قلنا الجواب عن ذلك هو, and we said the answer to that is ربي الله الذي رباني وربى جميع العالمين بنعمه وهو معبودي ليس لي معبود سواه. والدليل قوله تعالى الحمد لله رب العالمين الآية الأولى من سورة الفاتحة. And the answer to that is my Lord is Allah who nurtured me, who nourished me and all of creation with his favor. He is object of my worship. I do not have any object of worship other than him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The evidence is the statement of Allah, the Most High, in Surah Al-Fatiha, ayah 1, Alhamdulillah, all praise due to Allah, the Lord of all creation. السؤال الثالث, بما عرفت ربك, بما عرفت ربك, وما الدليل? And the third question is, how did you know your Lord and what is the evidence? قلنا جواب ذلك, we said the answer to that, قولنا عرفت ربي بآياته ومخلوقاته ومن آياته الليل والنهار والشمس والقمر. والدليل قوله تعالى ومن آياته الليل والنهار والشمس والقمر, الآية من سورة فصلت. ومن مخلوقاته السماوات السبع والأرضون السبع ومن فيهن وما بينهما. والدليل قوله تعالى الله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض, الآية من سورة إبراهيم. And the answer to that was, I know my Lord by his signs and by his creations. From his signs are the night and the day, and the sun and the moon. The evidence is the statement of Allah, the Most High, as in Surah Fussilat, ayah 37. And from his signs are the night and the day, and the sun and the moon. And from his creation are the seven heavens and the seven ears, and whoever and whatever is in them, and whatever is between them. The evidence is the statement of Allah the Most High, as in Surah Ibrahim, ayah 32. Allah is the one who created the heavens and the earth. إلى هنا انتهى بنا اللقاء الأخير. Up to this portion, the last session ended up with us. ونشرع اليوم لا عفوا لا بقي سؤالان مما أخذنا. There are two other questions of what we already explained. ما دينك وما الدليل. What is the fourth is what is your religion and what is the evidence. ديني هو الإسلام. جواب ذلك قولنا ديني هو الإسلام وهو الاستسلام لله بالتوحيد والانقياد له بالطاعة والبراءة من الشرك وأهله. والدليل قوله تعالى ومن يبتغي غير الإسلام دينا فلن يقبل منه وهو في الآخرة من الخاسرين. الآية من سورة آل عمران. My religion is Islam and it is to submit to Allah with tawheed and compliance to him with obedience along with this association from shirk and its people. The evidence is that the statement of Allah the Most High as in Surah Al-Imran Ayah 85, and whoever seeks other than Islam as a religion, it will never be accepted from him and he will be in the hereafter among the losers. السؤال الخامس, the fifth question, ما هي مراتب الدين? The fifth question is, what are the levels of the religion? الجواب, مراتب الدين ثلاثة وهي الإسلام والإيمان والإحسان. The answer is, the levels of the religion are three, and they are Islam, الإسلام, الإيمان, الإحسان. وقد سبق الكلام عن كل مرتبة وقلنا بأن الإسلام هو الأعمال الظاهرة لهذا الدين. And we already spoke about this widely, and we, as a conclusion, said that Islam is the apparent practices of this religion. والإيمان هو الأعمال الباطنة التي تكون في القلب من الإخلاص والنية والمحبة والحب والبغض وغير ذلك. And الإيمان is the hidden practices such as the faith, sincerity, love, hate, etc. والإحسان هو أن يكون العمل كله لله مبني على ما أوحاه إلى رسوله عليه الصلاة والسلام. And إحسان or goodness is that all the deeds of religion must be done sincerely to Allah, the Almighty, with no any partners, with no showing up, and must be established according to the that which Allah revealed to His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. واليوم نشرع في هذا واليوم نشرع في هذا الأمر الآخر وهو السؤال السادس. And today we go into this new matter or the sixth question. وهو قوله من نبيك وما الدليل. هذه من القواعد الأساسية في منهج السلف, التعلق بالدليل. So the sixth is, who is your prophet and what is the evidence? And this is one of the principles of the pious predecessors, to hang yourself to the evidences. The evidences. كما قال ابن القيم, as ابن القيم رحمه الله said, العلم قال الله قال رسوله قال الصحابة ليس بالتمويل. Knowledge is what Allah said, what the Prophet said, what the Sahaba said. It is not making things dodgy. نعم. قال من نبيك وما الدليل. He said, who is your prophet and what is the evidence for that. فقل, إذا قيل لك ذلك, if it is said to you that, فقل نبي محمد وهو ابن عبد الله ابن عبد المطلب ابن هاشم, وهاشم من قريش, وقريش من العرب, العرب من ذرية إسماعيل بن إبراهيم الخليل عليه وعلى نبينا أفضل الصلاة والسلام. والدليل قوله تعالى من سورة الأحزاب الآية 40, ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين. And the answer to this question, who is your prophet and what is the evidence of that, is to say, my prophet is Muhammad, son of Abdullah, son of Abdul Muttalib, son of Hashim, and Hashim is from Quraysh. And the Quraysh are from the Arabs, and the Arabs are from the progeny of Ismail, the son of Ibrahim Al-Khalil. May Allah give him the most excellent mentioning, as well as our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and render them both safe from any derogatory thing. The evidence for that is what Allah Ta'ala said in Surah Al-Ahzab, Ayah 40, Muhammad is not the father of any of your men, but he is the messenger of Allah and the seal of the prophets. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam huwa da'watu Ibrahim alayhi salam wa bisharatu Musa wa Isa alayhi salam. Muhammad is the sublimation of Ibrahim alayhi salam and the glad tidings of Musa and Isa alayhi salam. قال الله تعالى في سورة البقرة بالآية 29 بعد المئة. الله تعالى said in سورة البقرة 129 عن إبراهيم عليه السلام أنه قال في دعائه about إبراهيم عليه السلام that he said in his obligation, ربنا وابعث فيهم رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياتك ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة ويزكيهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم. Our Lord, and send among them a messenger from themselves who will recite to them your verses and teach them the book and wisdom and purify them. Indeed, you are the exalted and might, the wise. قوله سبحانه وتعالى ربنا وابعث فيهم رسولا. الرسول أعلى من النبي، فكل نبي رسول وليس العكس. And in the saying of Allah about the dua of Ibrahim, our Lord, and send among them a messenger from themselves. The messenger is higher than the prophet, because every prophet is a messenger, but not the other way around. فالنبي هو من أوحي إليه. As the prophet is the one who received revelation. ولكن قد يكون هذا الوحي تكملة لوحي نبي أو رسول سبقه. But this revelation might be a completion of the message of the previous prophet or messenger. وأما الرسول فهو الذي يوحى بشرع يوحى إليه بشرع جديد ينسخ شرع من قبله. As for the messenger is one who received new revelation that abrogates the revelation of the previous messenger before him. وقوله سبحانه وتعالى يتلو عليهم آياتك قوله منهم أي من أنفسهم كما جاء في الآية الأخرى أنه أن الله عز وجل قال the saying of الله تعالى منهم means from themselves and from the best quality among themselves, from the best quality among them. As Allah Ta'ala said in Surah Ali Imran, Ayah 164, قال تعالى في سورة Ali Imran, Ayah 165, لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم في قراءة من أنفسهم يعني نسبا وشرفا وخلقا. In this ayah, which is in Surah Al-Imran, recited as follows: لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم. Certainly did Allah confer great favor upon the believers when he sent among them a messenger from themselves. In other ayah, in other recitation, other way of recitation of this ayah, min anfasihim, from the best among them, and lineage, and manners, and characters, and behaviors, and everything. إذن الله عز وجل بيّن لنا هذا الأمر. So الله سبحانه وتعالى الله سبحانه وتعالى بيّن لنا الرسول بيّن لنا الرسول الله سبحانه وتعالى clarified to us the messenger. فقال رسولا منهم يتلو ما هي وظيفته. What is the duty of this messenger? يتلو عليهم آياتك. يتلو عليهم آياتك. Who will recite to them your verses. الآيات المقصود هنا بها الوحي المتلو القرآن وكذلك الوحي غير المتلو وهو الحديث. لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أرسل كما جاء في الحديث قال فإني أوتيت القرآن ومثله معه ومثله معه. As يعني here the verses means the revelation, whether it which is to be recited, which is the Quran, or the one which is not to be recited, which is the Hadith. As the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the Hadith, I was sent with the Quran and the life of it with it, meaning the Sunnah, the Hadith. وقوله ويعلمهم الكتاب ويعلمهم الكتاب. قيل الكتاب هو القرآن وقيل الكتاب بمعنى الشرع والتشريع التشريع. فيتعلمون التشريع المضمن في القرآن والمضمن في الحديث والذي لا يقوم الدين إلا به والذي لا يقوم الدين إلا به. And as in the saying of Allah, and teach them the book. It is said that the book here means the Quran, it means the Shara, the legislation, the legislation, the law that they have to perform accordingly, whether that which has been clarified in the Quran or that which is in the clarified in the Hadith. نعم. إذن الرسول النبي هو الذي الذي أرسله الله عز وجل ليبين لهم. So the prophet is that he who Allah Ta'ala sent to clarify to them what they don't know. كما قال الله عز وجل في سورة آل عمران. As Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala said in the ayah of سورة آل عمران. قال وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين. لفي ضلال مبين. Although they had been before, meaning before the Prophet was sent, in manifest error, in manifest error. فهذا النبي أرسله الله عز وجل معلما ومبشرا ونذيرا وهاديا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا ورحمة للعالمين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent this messenger as a teacher, as a glad carrier, as a warner, as a guide, as a light, as a light to show them the way, and as a mercy to all universes. كما بين ذلك ربنا عز وجل في كتابه العزيز في آيات كثيرة. As Allah, our Lord, the Almighty, has clarified that in the Quran and many verses in the Quran. إذن هذه هي الأصول الثلاثة التي يجب على كل مسلم ومسلمة تعلمها. So, as a conclusion, these are the three fundamental principles that every Muslim, male and female, has to learn them. والسبب بوجوب تعلم المسلم لهذا هو أنه لن يستقيم له دينه إلا بهذا، وأنه لن يستطيع الإجابة عن أسئلة القبر التي بها النجاة إلا بهذا، وأنه لن يفلح يوم العرض والجزاء يوم القيامة إلا بهذا. And the reason why it is obligatory about every Muslim male and female to learn this is that no one's religion would be fulfilled correctly except with this knowledge. And no one will be able to answer the questions of in the grave, the three questions in the grave, which based upon whether he is going to be pleased or tortured, except with these three questions, the answers of these three questions correctly. And no one would be secured and survived on the day of resurrection except as according to the these three questions, if he was one of those who were practicing them correctly after learning them or not. لذلك وجب علينا كمسلمين أن نتعلم ديننا. And that's why it is obligatory upon us as Muslims to learn our religion. لأن هذا الدين لا يصلح أن يبنى على جهل ولا يجوز أن يتجاهل العلم بعد بلوغ الإنسان. And as this religion cannot be established upon ignorance, nor that it is permissible for man, for the Muslim man or woman, to abandon the knowledge after it reached him. لأن الله عز وجل قد حذرنا من الصنفين كما في آية الفاتحة فقال سبحانه وتعالى اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. As Allah Ta'ala said in Surah Al-Fatiha, guide us to the straight path, the path of those who you bestowed favor upon, not the path of those misguided ones, nor those who you are angry with. والمغضوب عليهم هم اليهود والضالين هم النصارى. فاليهود أتاهم العلم فأعرضوا عنه والنصارى عبدوا الله بلا علم فضلوا. As for the Yahud, they were given the knowledge, but they ignored it and abandoned it. And the Christians, or the Nasara, they worshipped Allah, but upon ignorance, so they made massive and major mistakes in the worship of Allah. والله عز وجل قد أخبرنا أنه أنزل هذا الهدى وأنه يجب على الناس أن يهتدوا به ويتعلموه. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed us that he has bestowed this guidance and that the Muslims, human being and jinn, has to seek the success in their fulfillment of the duty of the of worship based on that. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كما قال الله عز وجل في سورة البقرة في الآية 38, as in Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 80, ayah 38, Allah Ta'ala there said, قُلْنَا بِطُوا مِنْهَا جَمِيعًا فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدَى فَمَنْ تَبِعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Allah Ta'ala said, we said, go down from it, all of you. And when guidance comes to you from me, whoever follows my guidance, there will be no fear concerning them, nor will they grieve. إذن لا بد من تعلم العلم والعمل به. So we have to seek knowledge of this religion and act upon it. وإلا فالعقوبة عظيمة في الدنيا والآخرة. Otherwise, the punishment is severe in this holy life and in the hereafter. قال الله تعالى في سورة طه, as Allah تعالى said in سورة طه, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى قَالَ رَبِّ لِمَ حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى وَقَدْ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا قَالَ كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَاتُنَا فَنَسِيتَهَا وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي مَنْ أَسْرَفَ وَلَمْ يُؤْمِنْ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِ وَلَعَذَابُ الْآخِرَةِ أَشَدُّ وَأَبْقَى. الله تعالى said in Surah Taha from ayah 120 3, and whoever turns away from my remembrance, meaning the revelation from the guidance that he sent down, indeed he will have a depressed life, depressed and difficult life, and we will gather him, meaning resurrect him, raise him on the day of resurrection blind. He then will say, my Lord, why have you raised me blind while I was once seeing? Allah then will say, thus did our signs come to you and you forgot, meaning disregarded them and ignored them, turned away from them. And thus we will this day be forgetting you, meaning abandon you. And thus do we recompense he who transgressed and didn't believe in the signs of his Lord, and the punishment of the hereafter is more severe and more enduring. لذلك أيها الإخوة يجب علينا أن نتعلم ديننا شيئا فشيئا حتى نكون منه على بيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. And that's why my brothers and sisters, we have to learn our religion gradually, little by little, until we become Abu al-Ith, like a very clear day. No one would miss that way except one who is destroyed. أسأل الله بمنه وكرمه أن يبصرنا بديننا وأن يعلمنا منه ما جهلنا وأن يجعلنا وإياكم من خيرة عبادي والله أعلم. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه, وإلى لقائنا القادم بإذن الله نستكمل في الحديث المنرقي. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
جزاك الله خير شيخنا, بارك الله فيك. Beautiful lecture, may Allah reward you.
آمين.
Sheikh, just I know we're very late for you, but a quick question. It's a bit of a strange question, but I'll ask it anyway, if you don't mind.
No problem. Go ahead.
So the brother says that in the grave, when they're asking questions, what language will it be?
Don't worry about the language, because Allah, he is the one who created all tongues, and he will fit you with the language that you know. And we have got no news to say what language. And even the deaf are going to speak that day. And on the day of resurrection, if you ask about language, on the day of resurrection, the mouths are going to be shut. What will speak? The hands, the legs, the skin, and the ear. What language? Allah knows best. Definitely, all those who Allah Ta'ala command to speak, they're going to speak. And they are going to be understood and talked to. So this is definite, but the language, we have no any evidence to say what language. More likely it is the Arabic language, because today there is no single language from that which the Prophet has spoken except Arabic. All the existing languages are newly invented languages after the Prophets. These were not the languages of the Prophets. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon them. These all are newly invented languages. So the Arabic language is the only language that a Prophet spoke with, which is still living till today, and it will remain until the day of resurrection, because the Quran was revealed in Arabic, and Allah promised that He is going to preserve the Quran, and it will return to Him, as in the Ahadith. Wallahu a'lam.
JazakAllah khair, Shaykhina. Strange question, but actually a beautiful answer. Barakallah feek.
Habibakumullah, barakallah.
One more question, barakallah feek, Shaykh, if you don't mind. Nah. So the brother asks, is the three questions in the grave fitnat al-mamat?
Nah. This is the trial of death, meaning after death. This is a trial, because one is going to be either in pleasure or in torment based on his answers. And the answers are not based on what you hear today and memorize. That it is based on how you responded to them in your life. If you practice them sincerely, then you will have the answers. If you practice them showing off, you will have no answer. If you did not practice them, you will have no answer. So what you need to do is just learn your deen, practice it, and the answer is going to be very easily spoken by your mouth in the grave, and you would be in pleasure. Wallahu a'lam.
JazakAllah khair, Shaykhina. Sorry, one more if you don't mind. Is there time?
Go ahead.
Brother says, is there anyone who won't be questioned in the grave?
Well, the Prophet ﷺ informed us that every mankind is going to be questioned in the grave. Every mankind. Except, of course, the prophets and messengers, because they are the prophets and messengers. Because he ﷺ said, إِذَا مَاتَ ابْنُ آدَمَ. He says, when the child of Adam died, and this covers all. Nah, wallahu a'lam.
JazakAllah khair, Shaykh. Barakallah feek.
Wa feekum barakallah. Hayyakum Allah. Wa narakum inshallah al-asbuha al-qadim. Bi-idhnillahi ta'ala.
Inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.